Hello everyone and welcome to ILAN Technologies presentation on what is VPN Matcher and how to use it. My name is Darren and I'm the Queensland sales rep at DrayTek Australia and New Zealand. Today we'll be looking at one way to deal with creating VPNs using private IP addresses which are often issued by LTE ISPs. DrayTek provides a solution for this called VPN Matcher and we'll look at what it does and how to configure it, including a step-through demonstration. Stay tuned at the end because we'll be online for 5 minutes afterwards to answer any questions. Don't forget you can pause the video or skip back any time if you'd like a longer look at anything or to hear it again. In some countries, local ISPs will only assign private IP addresses for subscribers because there's not enough public IPv4 addresses available anymore. In Australia, we tend to see this with 3G or 4G internet connections. We often see these connections showing private instead of public IP addresses on the WAN side. So these are addresses starting with 192.something or 10.something. This creates a major issue when it comes to creating VPN tunnels because the dial-in VPN server needs a public WAN IP address to be accessed. DrayTek's VPN Matcher service is a solution for this. When DrayTek routers are registered with the same DrayTek VPN Matcher account, they can locate each other, allowing them to establish a secure end-to-end encrypted VPN tunnel between them, even if the public IP address is hidden behind NAT or even if it's dynamic. DrayTek's VPN Matcher service is a type of stun server and can be found at vpn-matcher.draytek.com. You just need to register the routers involved with their MAC addresses and subnets, and the stun server will keep track of them, whether they are behind NAT or not. While it is primarily designed for DrayTek devices, it also includes any PC using DrayTek's smart VPN client. To demonstrate the VPN Matcher service, we'll use two DrayTek LTE routers, each using a SIM card with a private IP address. One will be a 2862 LTE model and the other will be a 2865 LTE model. We'll start with registration of both routers on the VPN Matcher website. I should also mention that this service is free for DrayTek users and most recent models are included. Okay, looking at the dashboard of our Vigor 2862 LAC router here, we see under IPv4 internet access that our LTE connection has a 10.xx IP address, which is in the private class. Over to our 2865 LAC, we see the same problem on WAN 6, so again we know we're behind NAT here. So to start with, go to vpnmatcher.draytek.com and log in. You can create a free account down here if you don't already have one. Here's both of our routers, which I've already set up, but just to go through that process, over here we click on Add Device, give it a name. That can be anything you like that will help you identify the device later. To get the LAN MAC address, go back to the dashboard. Here it is up here. Select and copy. When you paste it, be aware that it needs colons instead of dashes between each number, so you'll need to replace all of those. Then select the model type. This one is a 2862. Note that not all routers are compatible with the VPN Matcher site. Now select if the router is going to be a VPN server or client. And lastly, we need to enter the LAN subnet and the subnet mask. Back on our 2862 dashboard, we see the LAN subnet is 192.168.1.1. And we'll select the /24 subnet mask. I won't add that because we already have it set up. Let's review the settings, starting with the 2862 LAC. The description is correct. We have the right MAC address and it's in the correct format. It's going to be our VPN server and our LAN subnetwork and mask are correct. Checking the 2865 LAC, description is correct. MAC address is correct. It's going to be our VPN client. LAN subnetwork matches the LAN subnet on the router. So we can now see that the two routers are registered on the VPN Matcher website. Their subnets and masks are clearly displayed, as is the status of each server or VPN client device. Our router list key up the top here we're going to need in a moment, so we'll copy that to the clipboard now. To start creating the VPN tunnel, we'll start with our VPN server, which is the 2862 LAC. Go to VPN Remote Access and select VPN Matcher Setup. Click Enable. Enter the VPN Matcher website, which is vpn-matcher.draytech.com. Paste the router list key. Click OK. Then click on Detect Stun Server. And after a moment, you get confirmation that the router was detected along with the stun server IP address and port. And finally, click on the Get List button to get the details of the two routers registered in the VPN Matcher website. I've already created our VPN and it's up and running here, but I'll clear all that and start over so I can take you through the steps. The easy way to do that is to click on Set to Factory Default up here. So back to our VPN Matcher setup menu, click on Detect and Get List if you don't see any routers listed down here. Then click on Create Profile to start the wizard. Click on an index number, let's go with 1. Give the profile a name, I'll call it 2862 LAC. Choose a direction for the VPN, that is dial in for server and dial out for VPN client. The server address is generated by the VPN Matcher website. Key in a pre-shared key. Enter a peer ID, which is found on the router on the other side of the VPN. This one is 2865. And all of the rest will be preloaded by the VPN Matcher website. And click OK. If we check our LAN-to-LAN settings, we see our VPN is up and running, and that's because I've already configured our VPN client-side. Under the LAN-to-LAN profile, we see all of the settings have been automatically entered. Note the IPsec tunnel has been selected and the peer ID typed in as 2865, as well as the pre-shared key, which we entered in the wizard. The IPsec security method is auto-selected for you. And finally, the details of the remote and local network. Okay, over to our 2865 LAC, which is our client VPN router. The process is pretty much the same. Click on Create Profile, give it a name. This time we select the direction as Dial Out and the same pre-shared key. Local ID, which was labeled as Peer ID in the other router, so I better change the profile name to something different. And again, we see the local and remote IP details are automatically filled in by the wizard from the VPN Matcher website. Click OK. Oops, I forgot to select a profile. Let's go with 1. Click OK again. And done. Now if I click that profile, we see all of the details of our dial out VPN profile have been created for us. The call direction is now dial out. We have an IPsec VPN tunnel. Server IP host name is there. Same pre-shared key used. IKE Phase 2 settings are auto-filled in by the wizard, and all of the other necessary details such as remote and local subnets have been filled in by the wizard. Now if you go to the Connection Management section of the VPN Remote Access tab, you'll see that the VPN tunnel is up and running. Job done. So to summarise, we registered the two routers on the VPN Matcher website. We created a LAN-to-LAN dial-in VPN profile on the server router using the VPN Matcher wizard, and we created a LAN-to-LAN dial-out VPN profile on the client router. Now we have a VPN up and running between two routers, both using private IP addresses on their WANs. Okay, that's it for me, but please stay tuned. We'll be sticking around to answer questions in the live chat on the right of your screen for the next 5 minutes. If you're watching this after the live premiere, please comment below or call or email instead. You'll find more information about DrayTek products on our website at www.draytek.com.au. Feel welcome to email us at sales@draytek.com.au or give us a call on 02 983 8899. Don't forget to like and subscribe below, and if you'd like a notification of new premiere videos we're about to launch or anytime we put up a new video, please give the bell a click too. Thanks and bye for now.